I said get over here! Stop! What's that? Yeah, I have a batarang. Suck! Bullseye! Bah, bah, bah. Oh, these are goons? Yeah, you're on the floor, Johnny. Bah, 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 bah. I got this. I got... whoa. Hey. Hey. Hey, honey. Hey, baby. Hey, Grimes. What's up? Yeah, Tesla stocks are not doing so... not doing so good. Hey, what are you doing home early? Oh, God damn it. Yeah, okay, you caught. Okay, yeah. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah, laugh it up. I'm practicing. I'm getting ready for my big cage fight. No, not like the one we had sex in last night. Like a cage fight. You know what? Who am I fighting? You want to know? For real? You really want to know? Johnny Depp. Of course. Look, Johnny sent me a text saying that he wants to slice off my dick. Okay, so you know what? Man up. You want to take away my man parts? Man up. So I told him to man up and I said I want a cage fight. I gotta show him who's the alpha, babe. Come on. I gotta show him who's boss. So I wanna... gotta show him who's the alpha. You know what I... Yeah. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? I gotta show him who's boss. You know, is that the baby? Can you go take care of the baby, please? You wanna watch me practice? You wanna watch me boss? You know what I mean? I gotta show him who's the alpha. Because I'm no beta. Come on, babe. I'm not a beta, okay? And guess what? Guess what? You know who Conor McGregor is? Well, Conor McGregor, the UFC champion, his coach wants to train me to get me ready to fight Johnny Depp. Yeah, it's bananas. It's fucking bananas. What do you mean? What does he want out of this? Believe it or not, he wants a Tesla. It's a little bitch, we don't fuck with small talk. We associate with people that are known to call cops. See that shine from my wrist to my neck, so rocks. Gucci flip flops with Louis Vuitton socks. Man, I'm always doing work, the shit is non-stop. Fuck your bitch, blow inside a mouth just like a pop rock. Yeah, I've done a bit of dirt, but I've never... And welcome back to a brand new episode of Darth News. Special edition, let's get ready to rumble! I hope you're ready to rumble. I hope you brought your big boy pants and $100 bills. I only take new $100 bills. Let the games begin. So we got Johnny Depp and Elon Musk beefing it up. That's right. Johnny Depp apparently sent a few texts to Elon Musk saying he wants to cut off his dick and balls. Well, Elon responded to that in an interview saying that he would be down to fight Johnny Depp any day, anytime. I think, something like that. But basically, he's down to fight him in a cage. Cage fight. Yeah, cage fight, that's a good idea. They should have a cage fight. Either way, I had a wonderful time camping. I became one with Mother Nature, and it was a really, really nice time. Not that that's any of your goddamn business or part of the video. I just felt like saying that, so moving on. I believe my point was I could be spending my time right now giving you updates on the Johnny Depp case and how his last day of trial went and how did it go. I could do that, but I chose not to because I want to talk about the beef, because I'm smelling some fucking beefaroni and I want to talk about it. It's about to be a bloody battle royale between Elon Musky Balzania and Johnny Depp Dish Pizza. With extra cheese, baby. Yeah, and stuffed crust. He can stuff my crust any day. Better yet, I'll stuff his crust. So before I continue to rant and sound like a fucking idiot the longer I talk, let's go ahead and read the article with actual news. unlike my conjecture. Let's go ahead and read the news and see what the fuck is going on. Let's see what's cooking up in the beef stew kitchen. Let's see what beef is cooking up in the kitchen.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, preferably ladies, we're over here at the New York Post. The title reads, Conor McGregor's coach offers to train Elon Muskie Balzania for a fight with the great Johnny Depp. Can you believe the fucking gall on this mother effer? Can you believe this shit? Well, McGregor's coach says that he wants to help Elon Musk put Johnny Depp on Mars with a punch. Do you get it? Because, like, SpaceX and stuff, you know? Like, because Elon's all about, like, going to Mars and stuff. And, you know, how he sent the astronaut, like, into space with a car and stuff. There was someone in there. He killed somebody for sure. No, there was someone in there for sure. But, dude, he left the do not panic sign. Come on, man. The dude woke up from his anesthesia and he was like, oh, shit. And he saw the little sign that said do not panic and stuff. And he probably panicked and he freaked the fuck out. So, yeah, Elon's a murderer. But I think that was the joke, you know what I mean? Like, he wants to send him to Mars because it's funny, right? Because it's funny. I should probably stop smoking weed before I make videos. Did I say that out loud? If I did, let me know in the comments below if I should stop smoking weed before I make a video. Oh, yeah, there's more. Let's read more. And SpaceX boss Musk, 49, might have been just goofing around when he challenged Depp, 57, to a cage fight last week for allegedly threatening to remove his manhood, aka chopping off his dick and balls. However, now Conor McGregor's coach is offering to train the Tesla founder for the supposed showdown. If you need a coach, let me know. At Elon Musk, read the tweet Monday from John Kavanaugh, 43, who was named Coach of the Year at the 2017 MMA Awards. Kavanaugh quipped in a subsequent tweet saying, I kinda hope he throw me a Tesla if I do a good job. So you don't give a shit about Elon or John. You don't give a shit about you. All you care about is getting that new Tesla. Dude, that's sad, man. Now we know where your priorities lie. Okay, this is you know what? And if you're such a renowned coach, if you were Coach of the Year, you should be making enough money to afford a Tesla. Dude, they're like 35 grand. Cough it up. Anyway, the article continues. The trainer's outrageous offer has sparked mixed reactions from the, you guessed it, mixed martial arts community. Really? Well, let's see what's going on, shall we? Outstanding, tweeted former Bodog Fight bantamweight champion Tara La Russa, 42. Would be the biggest fight in combat history, commented another Twitter follower. Would it be the biggest combat fight in history? In history? Anyway, however, the other social media fight fans hoped that Kavanaugh would lend his expertise to coaching Depp instead. Now that's what I'm fucking talking about. Coach Depp, you're picking the wrong side, dude. Train the underdog. Get the underdog fired up, man. Everyone wants to root for the underdog. And you know what? I mean, Johnny's not an underdog in any sense of the word, but in a fight, maybe he would be. Because he's a lover, like I said, not a fighter. The fact that fans are telling him to lend his expertise and his coaching abilities to Johnny Depp says a lot. It says that Johnny Depp is winning the court of public opinion. He is winning in the eyes of his fans and the eyes of the public. It doesn't matter really what happens from here on out. We've all picked our sides. We've all picked Team Johnny. Like, it's just, it doesn't matter what comes out of these legal battles. He's already won. They say, unfortunately for MMA enthusiasts, it's unlikely that the celebrity grudge match will ever actually materialize. Oh, who would have guessed that? Musk threw down the gauntlet last week in an apparent jest while discussing Depp's highly publicized divorce trial with the New York Times. The interviewer had asked Musk about texts Depp had sent threatening to, and I quote, slice off his dick for allegedly sleeping with his wife Amber Heard, ex-wife Amber Heard, sorry, while they were still married, an accusation that the serial entrepreneur denied.
Of course he did. Of course Johnny sent those texts. He was pissed. He was angry. He was really going to slice his dick off. Or at least he thought about it, enough to text him. Why would Johnny send those texts? Why would he say such crazy things to Elon? Why would he do that? Because he's telling you the truth. That's why. Johnny was furious. He was livid. He was seeing red. Like me. J- Johnny was so pissed off. And of course, Elon Musky Balls is going to go ahead and say, never happened. Nope, never happened. Why would he deny the allegations? Why would he deny that these texts were sent to him? Well, because if he admitted that these texts were sent to him, then that would be nothing more than an admission of guilt. It would be him admitting that he's fucking guilty. It was Johnny being smart. He was being a Captain Jack Sparrow. He was trying to bait him. He was baiting him. Unfortunately, he's dealing with a Barbossa of types. He didn't take the bait. Just because he didn't take the bait doesn't mean it didn't really piss him off, because Elon was obviously pissed off in the interview. I mean, look, Johnny is a lover, not a fighter. Okay, he's not a Brad Pitt or a Rock. You know what I mean? He's not scrappy. He's just Johnny. You know what I mean? So yes, I think Elon might have the upper hand and might win in a fight. But if he did win, I think that would just make people hate him even more. It's not gonna be like, oh, you're the guy that beat up Johnny Depp in the cage fight. That's so cool, high five. No, people are gonna be like, dude, you're a douche. He's gonna be like, oh, what? Why does everybody hate me? I don't understand. Why does everybody hate me, dude? Telling you, Johnny is ready for a cage fight. We should just nickname Johnny Cage. Yeah, no more Johnny Depp. He is Johnny Cage. I want to see this fight.
He says, and I quote, if Johnny wants a cage fight, just let me know, responded Musk while giggling like a little bitch, like a little girl. The billionaire also laughed when asked about the court revelations that Depp had dubbed him, and I quote, mollusk, over his alleged philandering.
You're giggling. He was giggling. Do you find this funny? Is this funny to you, Mr. Mollusk? I know, it's pretty funny. It's pretty funny. Mollusk.
I hope he recovers from this situation, added the mogul, who recently welcomed a baby boy named Xie into the world with his partner, singer-songwriter Grimes, 32, who looks like she's 15. Just so you all know that, she looks like she's fucking 15 years old. Anyway, I didn't know it was a boy. I'm confused.
Yeah, and I really hope that Elon recovers from this severe case of beta male stupidity. I'm sure you have all heard the phrase, a wolf in sheep's clothing. Well, Elon Musk is, and always will be, a beta male in alpha clothing. Not that he does not know how to dress. He's got no fashion, but you know what I mean. Oh, so now it's a boy. Baby, you know, like just a week ago, you said you wanted it to be gender fluid. You wanted the baby to pick its own gender. Now it's a boy. You know, it's okay. I'm fine with that. Well, I'm fine with that. Yeah, let's leave it at a boy. Our son's name actually stands for xenomorphic asexual entity whose anus is a xerophilus, inbred and incel. It's an inbred incel. It's an incestual inbred incel. That's our baby. Yeah, no, I never told anyone, but yeah, Grimes is actually my niece. Yep, no, this is the first time anyone's ever figured this out. It's the first time I'm coming clean. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's frowned upon. Yeah, but you get used to it. You know what I mean?
The article reads, if the two big shots did hypothetically go toe to toe, Johnny might be out of his depth. Haha, funny pun, if you're reading it. Depth. See what they did there? They used his last name with depth. It's so original. So anyway, if they did hypothetically go toe-to-toe, it looks like Johnny would be out of his league, according to the highly unofficial online stat sheets. I repeat, according to the highly unofficial online stat sheets.
Okay, so there are two problems with the phrase highly unofficial online stat sheet. Yeah. Problem number unero, problema numero uno, it says highly unofficial in the fucking title. Not like unofficial, but highly unofficial. Why are you reporting this? Problem number duo, problemo numero duo is this. It's online. Yeah. Yeah. Do you know how much misinformation is spread online? Do you have any idea? I mean, have you watched my channel? Do you have any idea how fast fake news can spread?
Well, anyway, according to these highly unofficial online stat sheets, the Pirates of the Caribbean star, aka Johnny motherfucking Depp, weighs around 172 pounds and stands about 5 foot 10 inches tall, while Musk, on the other hand, weighs a reported 205 pounds. He could lose some weight, with a height of 6 foot 2 inches. So right off the bat, Musk has the advantage of height and weight over Johnny. So if anybody is going to train anybody to fight in this match, it should be Johnny Depp. They should be training. He should train Johnny Depp. This is stupid. Why are we even discussing this? This motherfucker just wants a Tesla. That's all he wants. He just wants his goddamn Tesla. This pathetic little piece of shit.
If I do a good job, maybe he'll give me a Tesla. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, okay, shut the fuck up. This is stupid. The only reason you want to help out Elon is because he has the advantage, and you know that. So you want to amplify his advantage, make sure he wins, and get your Tesla. The automotive magnate also recently revealed on the Joe Rogan Experience podcast that he took Taekwondo as a kid. Yeah, he was kicking ass as that purple and yellow belts. Yeah, he was beating those kids up. And he's now interested in pursuing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Yeah, that's right. He's interested in pursuing it. Okay, so there's two problems here. Let's discuss the two problems, shall we?
Problem number one. He took Taekwondo as a kid. I'm not going to elaborate. And problem number two, he said he's going to think about pursuing Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, meaning he's thinking about pursuing it, meaning he hasn't done it. So he's thinking about doing something in the future and hasn't done something for many, many years in the past. Doesn't sound too scary. And that about wraps up that episode of Darth News Special Edition. Let's get ready to rumble. Thank you so much for tuning in. I do appreciate it. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe, or do one of those three. And if you really like my content, like even a little bit, please, please hit that goddamn notification bell right now. Hit that bell. Or you could go to darthnews.com and buy some merch. That's right. Yeah, you can buy some merch. By the way, there's women's tees, women's tanks, men's hoodies, women's hoodies. No, just men's hoodies. And the website finally takes credit cards. Yes, no more pesky PayPal. In case you don't have PayPal, you can now just go into your mom's purse or your grandma's purse, pull out their credit card, go to darknews.com, and buy yourself some goddamn merch. I'm so sorry, I know. I've been trying to stop saying the GD word as much, you know, in case there is a God, because I don't want to go to hell. I do not want to go there. I just got done binge watching Lucifer. And if that is real, I know it's a TV show, but if it's real, no thank you. I want to go to heaven. Yay!
Took a trip to heaven. I found God in myself. Told him my confessions. Take a trip to heaven. You found God on your shelf. Which of us is guessing? We've been fighting for too long. What do we care? What do we care? Took a trip to heaven. To have